Hi, my name is Marianne Camilleri. I'm your new host of Life Enrichment Academy, Our Voice. And today we are going to talk about our LEA locations. Today I have Leslie Alsheimer Strunk from Monroe's LEA. She's the director of day services. She directs Ypsilanti as well. I have Derek Hardwood from...
I'm from LEA Warren, Shelby, and Howell.
Right. Thank you. How's this past year been for you guys?
How's
good? Good. 2022. What a year.
It sure was.
Yeah.
I like the kind of slogan at the comeback year, right?
Yeah.
We had the COVID shutdown in 2020.
Right.
2021 was the beginning of the comeback, and then 2022 we kind of roared back.
Right.
We brought a lot of things back, which we'll get into, and then leading up into 2023, which is hopefully not what we're going to, you know, go past where we were pre-COVID.
Correct.
So it's like you got to get knocked down to go all the way back up sometimes.
Yeah, I think we're getting there.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, and that's what we're going to go over, some of the things we brought back and some things that, you know, we've added new and where we're headed in 2023.
Yep. We also here at LEA New Haven, we have two new case coordinators, Melissa and Angie. They were former CSS staff, so they are doing really good. We also did our annual walkathon here at the building this year because of COVID, and we did very well.
I believe the Warren and Shelby location still had it at our same old usual spot. Unfortunately, New Haven was shut down during that time, right, Derek?
Yes, that's one of the things we brought back. First time since prior to COVID, we brought back the walkathon, which was always a huge event, fan favorite. It's a good fundraiser.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, we had it back at Freedom Hill, which was awesome. Warren and Shelby got together. Unfortunately, like you said, New Haven had to back out the last minute due to a shutdown.
Mm-hmm.
But it was pretty cool how flexible and fast thinkers that you guys were and planned your own like makeup walkathon.
Yeah, our guys really enjoyed it. We had our micro businesses selling their items. We had
CC Plus come out, Peggy
from CC.
She led us in dancing. We had a very generous donation from Edna Brown, who is the CMH support coordinator, who made a beautiful chicken fattoush salad for everybody.
It was so good.
Nice.
So it was fun.
We made the best of what we had.
Yep, and some of our guys said it was the best day they've ever had in a long time.
That's cool. And that's one thing we learned through the COVID, I think, is being able to be flexible and change things on the fly.
Yeah.
And reschedule things, because
for sure
the last 3 years have been
really
a bunch of rescheduling.
Yeah. Bunch of rescheduling.
So, no, you guys did a great job with that. I will say we missed you there because the Freedom Hill thing was great.
I know.
Weather was perfect.
I always
look
forward to seeing everybody there. You know, consumers that have gone to other programs, to other LEAs, I get to see them, and they're so excited to see us. So.
It's like a reunion.
Yeah, for
big
sure.
Big reunion, yes.
Had a big dance party, a lot of walking.
Well, during that time, while you guys were in person doing your walkathon, and we unfortunately had to be closed down due to a COVID exposure, LEA New Haven was offering virtual services, so we had many people in attendance with that. We're still continuing to offer them daily, as well as snow days, or the event that there's building issues. We always offer the virtual services on a daily schedule.
Yeah,
it's nice having that as an option.
It is.
And again, that's something that came from COVID, which COVID stunk, right? Like, we had to shut down and build back up, but new things are coming from it, like the virtual services
and
the flexibility.
When
we
first started virtual services, you know, it was all new to us.
Oh, yeah.
You know,
yeah.
Zoom, everything
had to start
was new to
scratch.
Us, so we had to think outside the box.
Yep.
And once we got it up and going, we were more comfortable in what we were doing and got a lot of praise from the guardians and the consumers.
Well, I would like to take a moment and thank you two, because they were very helpful in getting us started.
Yes. Also, this year, last year, we did our first annual haunted house. We had a lot
That's
of
fun.
Animated characters.
We had a sister agency that came out to join.
And the Horiat Man's Club came and donated candy and passed out candy during the event. And it was fun. Everybody dressed up, and we had a great time.
What did you guys do?
Well, first, didn't you guys win some contests too?
We did.
Oh, we did. Yes.
We did. We're very active in the community since we've come back from COVID, and we won the New Haven Village Scarecrow Contest.
Yes.
We're the home of the winners.
Yes.
Pretty cool.
Yes, we had.
It just shows the kind of army you have.
Yeah, we got a lot of support from our LEA family, and there was a vote on Facebook, and. We got the votes, and we won.
We have the numbers, so if there's ever a vote,
we got the
come
numbers.
See us. We'll get you guys a lot of numbers.
Yeah.
LEA Warren, Shelby Howell, just continue to grow their numbers and try to get, you know, back to where they were pre-COVID number-wise. They're doing a great job. Just like New Haven, they have a lot of new administration members, case coordinators, admin assistants, assistant managers, lots of turnover. But I think at all the sites now, they have great teams. They all get along, they work hard, and they're doing a great job.
Yeah.
One of the things the Warren Building brought back was the talent show, which is always a big hit. And this was the first year we'd done it since 2019. So it was a 3-year hiatus. They did Christmas, I think it was Welcome Back to Christmas or something along that lines. They had about 400 people come watch. I think it was 400 to 500. It was great.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun. Success as always.
Can that auditorium fit all those folks? Are you going to have to go bigger?
I think it holds like 600. So okay. We got another 100 to 200 spots, but yeah, it'd be cool one day to get even bigger.
You're kind of close. You're going to have to go back to Macomb Performing Arts.
Yeah.
Bigger auditorium, bigger stage.
Yeah.
But they love it. We get Paul Mitchell still to come out and do hair and makeup. They feel like superstars. Great. They get on stage. We have DVDs coming out soon. It was a good time. Good. Great. It really puts you in the Christmas spirit.
Yeah.
When we do Christmas ones. This year, we're probably not going to do Christmas because I think we did it in 2019 and 22. So we'll try something new this year. But yeah, they love it. They're already asking about the next one.
Next one.
We'll be coming up fast with how fast time goes. But.
Yeah, the time flies fast. LEA this past fall, the second week of December, we had our first craft show ever. And we had about 17 outside vendors that came in. And we ran our show Friday and Saturday. And we had an actual food vendor show up on Friday. His name, the
Pop Sweets from the Streets. And we are very thankful that they took time to come, and they even did a live footage of our vendor show.
Yeah, so it was
That's
great.
Cool.
And put it on his Facebook page.
The food was really good as well.
Good food's always. Yeah, it's always good to have good food.
We had a good turnout too for the craft show.
Good. Very good.
And this past year, we're probably going to, and I know we're going to have an April craft show. And then in the fall, we'll have another craft show.
Kind of like an opening day craft show.
Yeah.
Some Tiger baseball and some crafts.
That'll be
that'd
great.
That'd be fun.
And then also, we're going to get our Tasty Fixing truck back up and running.
Yeah.
We always used to do that on the Tiger opening day, didn't we? And then we would have hot dogs.
Yep. We'll do that this year.
It's good.
Wow, back in the day. Yeah. I did want to mention that my Washtenaw location moved over the last year. Last February, they moved from Saline to Ypsilanti, and we're now in a smaller, more affordable, integrated location.
Yes.
And we're still hiring. We're still in the process of hiring. They are still getting tours from individuals, and we do have a couple new folks that started up there, so that's good news.
That's great news. And I helped with that move, actually.
Yes, you did. You did. Thank you very much. And then also my Monroe location. Monroe is still going strong. We're in the process of hiring right now there. We want to bring additional folks back. The 20 and Below store that's downtown, part of the downtown business, they were very involved this year with trick-or-treating, the tree lighting, and also being open additional hours the day after Thanksgiving and later nights, just so people had the opportunity to come and go shopping. And a big thank you to LEA Howell, who donated a lot of merchandise for our store.
That's great.
Yeah.
How's the location of Howell?
Howell's doing great. Like Leslie said, donate a lot of their stuff. They had a 20 and Below, and due to different circumstances, it didn't go so well. So we turned it into a gym for the individuals.
Awesome.
Yeah, so they have more space now for services, and they work out in there. the girls there, Leah and Melissa, did a great job turning that building into that gym. And just over there, they could use a couple staff, like everybody, and keep getting numbers up. But yeah, they're doing great out there, and everybody seems to be moving right along.
In the right direction. Yeah.
We're moving forward. We're not looking back.
Yeah.
No, we're not going to look back.
Like we said, 2022 was the comeback year.
Yes.
And that's where we're going to continue into this year.
Do you guys have any great plans for your locations this year? Anything new?
We are going to, well, it's not new, but we're going to schedule that walkathon pretty quickly because I think last year was the first time we did it in May.
Yeah.
We used to do it in September, and so the weather was not as hot.
Right.
So it was nice. So we're definitely going to do that again. We're kicking around some new ideas too. Like you guys mentioned, the food truck's coming back.
Yep.
So just stay tuned, I guess we can say.
Derek, you know, I'd like to throw in there that you and I wrote a grant, and we were able to purchase additional technology equipment. And we got it for all the locations. We purchased Kindle Fires. We got smart boards. We got Arrow Gardens that a lot of our individuals have grown herbs, vegetables, that type of thing. And you're right, the Oculus, that's so fun, the virtual reality.
Oh, yes. It's cool.
Oh, yeah, very cool.
Yeah. Cool. Roller coaster ride.
Yeah, you put that on
whatever,
and
yeah.
You don't know where you are. The smart boards have been great.
Yeah, really. Smart boards are a big hit.
They're a big hit. And we just brought back our technology class because it was in a smaller setting. And now that we got the Kindles and the smart boards, the consumers are really happy.
Mm-hmm.
We can do more hands-on on those smart boards.
Yeah, and I think in 2023 now, technology is such a big part in this world.
Oh, yeah.
It's so important that we have that stuff here.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to continue to look for new things technology wise to bring into the buildings.
Yes.
And that's very important nowadays, especially what we learned from the pandemic that, you know, we were all kind of in a panic just trying to be able to stay in touch with each other. Like, what do they have? What do they, you know, and a lot of folks did not know how to use technology.
Right.
And now they're forced to.
Yes.
So we want to be able to help them learn.
Yeah, that's a big problem. A lot of our consumers don't know how to use a computer or even a phone. So that's, I know Matt from our tech class was showing them how to use a phone and how to text the other day. And they enjoyed it. They were actually texting me. Yeah. So they'd had somebody to text, you know. So they did great. And I know our virtual tech class would like to start virtual bowling. Maybe a virtual bowling league.
Is that like Wii bowling?
We're bringing it back. We're going to bring back the Wii.
The Wii, that's awesome.
Yeah. I mean, I remember back in the day when I played the Wii with my boys.
Yeah.
I was a pro bowler. Yay. So, yeah, I think that would be great. I mean, our consumers love to bowl.
Oh, yeah.
You know, so why not try it?
I think it's a great idea.
Yeah, great.
So if you're listening, Nintendo, maybe update a new gaming system with a new kind of Weeble.
Yeah.
That's been out a long time, huh?
Yeah, I'm fond of the golfing. I like the golf a little bit better than the bowling.
The tennis is kind of fun, too.
Yeah.
The Wii tennis.
I have played that. I played the basketball, which is fun, mm-hmm. and the ping pong. That's great, too. And I think that'll get more active as well.
Yeah.
We want them more active.
Oh, for sure.
Anything else you guys like to talk about?
No, like we said, 2023, we're going to continue to grow, continue to move forward, and stay tuned for new and exciting things.
Yes, I can't wait.
On the horizon.
Can't wait for the next podcast.
Yes.
Yeah, thank you for stepping up and volunteering to be the new host.
Oh, you're welcome. You're welcome.
Mike Leon, you know, retired, and we miss him dearly, but we appreciate you stepping up and being the new host, and it's going to be a good ride.
Yep. Big shoes to fill for you, but I know you can do it.
I'll try. My best.
Yes.
All right. Well, thank you, Derek and Leslie, and we will talk soon.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.